Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So today I'll show you how to create a shake transition. So normally when you do a shake transition, you would keyframe the position of your clip, and that's okay, but it's impractical if you have a lot of transitions. So today I'll show you a simpler and better approach, and that is to use the wiggle expression. So let's jump right into After Effects. And here I have already set up my project, and let's do a preview. So the first thing you want to do is to open up the position property and then alt click on the stopwatch to bring up the expression editor, and in here you type wiggle. So the first value we will put in is the frequency, that is how many times this clip will wiggle per second, and the second value we put is the amplitude, or in this case how much position is able to shift in each wiggle. So here I'm typing 1,100, which means that it will wiggle one time per second and amplitude is 100. So let's increase the frequency up to 20, and already you can see that it's shaking, and this is the effect that we want for the transition. And now we need to control the wiggle so that it only shakes during the transition, and that is where slider control comes in. So let's create a new adjustment layer, and let's bring up the slider control effect and drag it to the adjustment layer, and I will rename this position frequency. Then let's go back to the expression and let's remove the first value, and then you can click on the pick whip and drag and drop it to the slider that we just created. So now the frequency value is controlled by this slider, and currently it's set to 0, and that's why nothing is happening. And now we will keyframe this slider to control the frequency of the wiggle. So let's first set a keyframe, and then at the transition, let's set another keyframe with value 20, and let's add another slider control for the amplitude. So I will rename this to position amplitude, and then remove the 100 here, and do the same thing. Use the pick whip and drag it to the slider. So let's set a keyframe of 0 here and another keyframe of 100 here. And now let's copy this expression and paste it at the other composition. And then let's set the last keyframes with value 0 for both sliders. And it looks something like this. And you can play around with the duration of the transition and the value. So here I will increase the amplitude up to 150. And then there are a few things we want to improve here. So the first thing we want to do is to turn on the motion blur. So let's check the motion blur boxes and turn on the global motion blur function. And the second thing we want to do is to fill the black background. So let's use an effect called motion tile and drag it and drop it to the clips. Then let's check mirror edges and increase the output width and output height. And let's see how it looks. Now it's looking much better. And you can play back and adjust the position frequency and position amplitude as you see fit. And everything is done within this one adjustment layer. And now all you need to do is to copy and paste the keyframes. And you will get a different shake in each transition. And of course, you can increase or decrease the values as you go along. So let's do a preview. And of course, you can customize it even further by making the keyframes ease and then changing the speed graph. But in this case, I like how it looks, so I will skip that. And that's the basic concept of how you can create a shake transition using wiggle expression combined with slider control. And if you want to take things up a notch, you can also apply it to the rotation. And this is the end result. So I hope you guys liked the transition, and I will see you in the next one. We'll be right back.